But we begin tonight with a search for a cold-blooded killer.
Detroit police releasing new video in the investigation of that double murder at an East Side senior complex. They are calling the woman seen here a person of interest because she was driving the suspect's vehicle right around 9 this morning in the 7,000 block of Mack.
7 Action News reporter Simon Shaycat with more on the investigation.
Detroit police say that double murder that was carried out here at this senior apartment complex was fueled by a suspect who was already a career criminal and under the influence of cocaine.
You was a coward. You was a coward to shoot her in her head. And you knew she had no other where to run to. Then you go outside and you kill somebody else. You have no heart. You was heartless.
Whoopi Johnson grieves the devastating loss of her mother, Bernice Clark. Bernice and security guard Kenneth Hall were shot and killed by alleged gunman 69-year-old James Fleming on Tuesday night. Prior to that, Fleming, who's a registered sex offender, lived here on Dickerson, allegedly sexually assaulted a 30-year-old woman whom he was doing drugs with at the same senior complex.
Turn yourself in. You cannot run. You cannot run.
I'm still sad about my grandma being killed, but she in a better place than me.
Police say the 30-year-old woman got away and pulled a fire alarm. Then Fleming went outside and got his gun, which he used to commit those horrific acts. We've also learned it was the first day on the job for security guard Kenneth Hall.
Nothing but a cowardly act, and we know who this person is.
Fleming is thin with light complexion, 6'5" to 6'7", with short hair, wearing black. His vehicle is a 2001 Chrysler Town & Country minivan, dark blue colored with a Tennessee plate. In the meantime, loved ones of a victim remain heartbroken.
You could take her, but you can't take her soul. Her soul gonna live on within me and within my daughter. This is her grandbaby.
Detroit police say the man they're looking for has some ties to the state of Tennessee and could potentially be trying to make his way there. If you have any information, contact Detroit police right away. From Detroit's East Side, Simon Shaycat, 7 Action News.